Yeah, I'm going live because I gotta show you this this oldie but goodie from 22 years ago. This is when Dave Chappelle had his own stand-up comedy special on HBO, and it's called Killing Them Softly, and it's gonna be on HBO. Visualize, you'll listen to this shit. That's Dave Chappelle, folks. You go back to what he's doing from Nutty Professor all the way to Half Baked, Screwed. You know what I mean? And then Blue Streak and shit. He's killing them softly in this fucking comedy. That's what he did. Here's Dave Chappelle, bitch. It's Dave Chappelle, bitch. Yeah. I gotta keep doing this, bro.
I got it on, folks.
So I gotta dislodge these earphones, bro. Hold on.
All right, no. One. That make it good to come home, boy. I swear. I know, man. It's been a while. It's been a while. These things different.
Yeah.
I'm a god, man. It took me years to be able to do this show, but DC has changed.
Yes, right?
It's different now.
Maybe it changed in the District of Columbia.
There's a lot
DC.
Of white people walking around. I don't know.
I didn't get a chance to play JD, but man, I might go watch.
I mean, I left Kill DC himself. In the 80s. It was not like this in the 80s. When crack was going on. Remember when crack was going on?
I heard about that shit.
At DC from Virginia with binoculars and shit.
I wrote about this in my composition, a page of my composition tablet.
Well, it looks dangerous. Not yet.
I wrote about this shit. Yeah. That's right, nigga.
New white people.
That's
you
that
can't
shit.
Tell these white people. I try.
That's what's got people high, thought, nigga.
The hell is wrong with you?
Ooh! What is wrong with you, boy?
Those days are over. I'm glad that, you know, like we're doing a show here by Howard, you know, and you see like white people come out, and that's good. One thing I'm seeing, you'll be walking down the street and you'll see like a group of black dudes walking. Not just any old black dude, we talking, you know, thugs.
Gangsters, thugs, talking, you know, crooks.
I mean, some thugs. And in a group, they got like one or two, sometimes as many as three white guys will be with them. You ever seen this shit?
Yeah.
Let me tell you something about those white guys. Those white guys are the most dangerous motherfuckers in them groups.
Yeah, they're dangerous.
Well, it's true. It's true, man. There ain't no telling what they've done to get them black dudes respect.
They do.
But them black dudes have seen them do some wild shit, I'll tell you that. I've been trying to tell brothers that. Every group of brothers should have at least one white guy in. I'm serious, for safety.
Yeah.
Because when the shit goes down, somebody's going to need to talk to the police.
The police is going to believe them motherfuckers. Go some drugs. I mean, they got to go some drugs. I got going into D.C. and New York, nigga.
Uh-oh. Ernie, you want to get this one? Come on now. Come on now.
I had to clip my nails. Because
black people are very afraid.
I understand they look like a $2 hoe.
Oh,
I said
they
look like a $2 hoe on the fucking screen. My screen's different.
We just afraid of them. We got every reason to be afraid.
Now,
you know what I mean?
See,
like,
that? I don't have to look like a $2 hooker.
You know, nobody
says
you lose your driver's license and your registration, right?
I'm good.
See? So you have a nails cut. That's not what they say to us.
What? No, it ain't.
You wouldn't believe what they say to us.
What?
Spread your cheeks and lick your sack.
Like, oh! Lick your cheeks and lick your sack.
Oh! I got a driver's license too.
What?
The easier ways to prove who I am and shit. What does that prove? I can't go to the bank like that. Cash my check? What do you mean you don't have any ID? Wait a minute.
Hey, man. I swear you...
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Chappelle. Right this way.
I spread your sack.
Why don't you spread your cheeks on the beginning?
Spread your cheeks and lift your sack. Spread your cheeks and lift your sack. That's what cop says. That's what cop said. Spread your cheeks and lift your sack.
You'll be a real
Mr. Chappelle.
I'll pull up next to you. It won't be no big deal for you, but you know what? I'll fucking fall apart. Oh, don't look over there.
Motherfucker.
But I didn't always.
Anytime you go drive, you ain't smoke no weed, you ain't do nothing. They smoke no weed, you ain't pick no handy, you ain't do shit, nigga.
I was in New York City.
Even you in the NY.
No, I was hanging out with a friend of mine. He's a white guy.
You know? Hang out with the homies and shit.
And we were lost.
We ain't with the white people there. I just got back from hell. I got back
from lost in the high.
Getting the shit on.
My white buddy, he was smoking a joint.
Niggas is always high before half baked. Niggas is always high when time half baked was on. I couldn't find the full movie half baked because I had to find these. Yes, it's special.
I'm gonna ask him for directions.
You're asking for directions now.
I said, Chip, no, Chip, don't do it.
Don't do it, Chip.
What? He was walking over there. This man was high as shit.
Excuse me.
Oh,
excuse me, sir. Touching him and shit. Excuse me.
Oh, shit.
Need some information. Start confessing things you shouldn't confess. I'm a little high.
Oh, he's always a little high.
All I want to know, which way is 3rd Street? The cop was like, hey,
Third
take
Street.
It easy.
3rd Street? What is wrong with that
You're
nigga?
You're on 3rd Street.
What is wrong with that nigga? What the fuck?
You better be careful. Go ahead, move it. Move it.
Oh,
shit. That's
all that happened. That's
the end of the story.
Now,
I know that's
Jesus, look at sack.
That shit is fucking incredible, isn't it? I'm telling you, a black man would never dream.
He says, go this way. He says, go this way, man.
It's a waste of weed.
That's always going to be a waste of marijuana and weed. Yeah, it's a waste of marijuana. They be getting high. When they get on the beach and shit. That's what you see on South Central movie, man.
That's how you brought the PCP in there. I seen this on South Central. But then another time, me and Chip are driving. I'm not driving. Chip is driving, and he's driving a little crazy. He's been drinking.
Chip is drunk, man. You gotta take the wheel, man. Chip is too drunk to be driving to take the wheel, man. You take the wheel, man. Take the wheel. You gotta grab your helmet, man.
We stop at a red light.
And you go out there and get some puss.
And I'll never forget it. Chippy looks at me, he's all drunk.
That's like E4. We'll talk about like that. I said, I got my helmet, man.
I'm gonna race him.
I know it's a bad idea.
He
talked about this alibi
but
shit.
I
That's when
I tried to explain him what a bad idea, but all that came out was, well, nigga, sometimes you gotta race. I don't know.
Oh.
Man, that light turned green and Chip took off. Zigzagging and shit so no one could pass. The other car didn't know he was racing.
He took off, bro.
Then the police seen us and pulled us over. And you understand, I'm scared as shit. I mean, come on, the car smells like weed. I've been speeding. This man is fucking drunk.
Yeah, he is drunk.
I'm scared. Chip was not scared at all. It was weird. He didn't turn his radio down. Isn't that weird a little bit?
He ain't scared.
I mean, if you get pulled over, wouldn't you
Chip ain't scared, dog.
Down? Somebody would get
scared.
Their ass beat to a soundtrack.
Chip's never scared. He's never scared, dog.
You know what I'm saying? Chip had the music blasting. We're not gonna take it.
Whoa! That Twisted Sister shit?
Not gonna take it. Close your butt cheeks.
Oh, close your butt cheeks, he says.
Let me do the talking.
Let me do the talking tonight.
Well, know what he said?
What he say? What he
it's
say?
Almost exactly what he said.
It's all like white people say. It's all like white people talk.
Sorry, officer. I didn't know I couldn't do that.
I'm a fucking shot.
Motherfucker.
The cop said, well, now you know. Get out of here.
Shit. You scared the police, nigga.
Okay, I will. Thank you.
This nigga scared the police.
What's wrong with you, babe?
Shit. I didn't know I couldn't do that.
You didn't know you couldn't do it. You know.
Because I did know I
it's
couldn't do
my
that.
It's all fucking sweet, a dirty fucking bug. Walls gotta be fucking we did. I'm sorry, bro.
I wasn't shocked at the audacity. I was just shocked because I would have never thought to say that. I don't think any black dude would think to say that because they know we know the law.
Yeah.
Every black dude in this room is a qualified paralegal and shit. He knows
it. Uh-huh.
I mean, if one of us even start to do something wrong, an old black man will pop out of nowhere. Nigga, don't do that. That's 5 to 10.
Old man will just pop out. Just like a bitch come out of fucking birthday cake and shit.
Well, we know the law.
Surprise!
That chip didn't even know he couldn't race. I'm not saying I don't like police. I'm not saying that. I'm saying I'm just scared of them. Nothing wrong with that.
I don't like cops.
Sometimes we want to call them too.
Whoa.
Somebody broke into my house once. It's a good time to call them, but I don't know.
Yeah.
House is too nice.
Nice
ain't a real
house.
Nice house, but they'd never believe I lived in it. He's still here. Oh my God.
Yep.
Open and shut face, Johnson.
Yeah.
I saw this once before when I was a rookie.
It's happened when you're a cop.
Nigga broke in and hung up pictures of his family everywhere.
That's what's happened when you're a cop.
Well, let's sprinkle some crack on him and get out of here.
Let's go, man. Let's leave the alley, man.
That whole brutality thing. It's knowledge, man. There was a time when only minorities really knew about that. I'm not going to say white people didn't believe us, but you were a little skeptical.
No, I was going to talk about minorities.
We printed knew it was true.
Let's see, man.
And then Newsweek, white people are like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Honey, did you see this?
Do you see it now?
Apparently the police have been beating up Negroes like hotcakes.
That's the same thing they have no more story than that one with Rodney King, motherfucker. Four police officers whooped Rodney King's ass, bro. Yeah. Look this.
I mean, maybe you should have seen something a little suspicious.
Whooped Rodney King ass. Some more story nighttime one. They beat his ass up and then stomped him and beat him down like he was a ravaged fucking beast.
Savage animal. Who gets
bro?
Shot and sprinkles crack on themselves? Nobody like you.
Right. I was a fucking kid when Rodney King got his ass whooped. I was 8 years old when Rodney King got his ass beat by the LAPD officers. They were working for Dead Chief Bill Gates.
I'm a paranoid guy. That's how I am. I'll be scared to call 911 for anything, even if it's like a fire or anything.
He's talking about some fucking. These white police officers are beating up Negroes and in the streets and everything.
I'll say anything if I'm scared. That shit is private.
They probably put four niggas next and shit. That's worse than what happened. Two years ago, George Floyd, Minnesota, Minneapolis, George Floyd gets kneed to death by his fucking out of control crooked cop.
Hi, Bob. Hi. Yes, we just got hold of a copy of Dave Chappelle's Frantic 911 emergency call.
Oh.
Remember, viewers, some of this language is disturbing.
It's disturbing what you say? That's all good. Yeah. It's just some disturbing language.
Hello?
Like he
emergency. Help! Help, motherfucker, they're coming to get me!
Hey, come on and get me. Calm down,
sir, where are you?
Oh, I shit on myself. I can't stop crying.
Ooh, who like a fucking baby? 30,
40 times a day. All my buddies will be at my funeral looking at me.
You know, they've shit on themselves, right?
Caught on the knees. Right,
oh, he's shit so bad. Give me help, nigga.
Man, I can't defend myself.
Need help, nigga. You fucking it's shit yourself.
It's not a nice thing to do.
Oh, no. Oh,
I didn't expect the same. Of course you're going to be scared.
What?
It's an emergency. There's nobody calls 911. Cool and relaxed.
That's worse than you shit on yourself.
Oh, emergency.
Worse than you shit on yourself.
Hey, 911, how are you? Yeah. Look. There's a group of hooded white men gathering outside of my house.
And they're the motherfucking Ku Klux Klan, nigga.
Get out here, man.
Dave, they're the fucking Ku Klux Klan, nigga.
I gotta go.
Yeah, KKK, nigga. Ku Klux fucking Klan, nigga.
You guys trying to hurt.
These guys are hanging outside your house and trying to burn a cross, nigga.
It's too much pressure. That's my problem. I can't handle pressure.
That's a
sometimes pressure.
I suck at a Cat Williams impersonation.
Fake, and they make you fake.
It's like
that's
not your nose, nigga.
You're like, I don't even talk like that. I get sick of that shit.
Oh God,
I do. It just makes me sick. Sometimes I'll talk crazy just to make myself feel better. You know, and start talking like crazy. You ever hear this voice? Man. That's how bad guys used to talk in the 40s.
It's just like Rocky and Muggsy.
I talk like that.
It's like Rocky and Muggsy.
Somebody put the pressure on me.
Shut up, Maxie.
The police pull me.
It's like Muggsy was like,
hold you over. Nah, because I'm black. Shut that trap, bro.
Boom, go to sleep. They did that shit on fucking cartoons.
It's not illegal to talk like that.
That shit's fucking weird.
Nah, they know I don't talk that like shit's, that.
Shit's like this.
Stop talking like that, Cobber. Nah. Sorry, talk, see?
Come here. Yeah, come here. That's some Rocky Muggsy shit.
Like
that was some Rocky Muggsy shit. That's some old school. That's some old school. Rocky Muggsy shit. That's what they do that too.
We know what's going on.
I see on South Park, these motherfucking people like these guys are like caricatures of fucking cartoon characters from the fucking 40s, 50s, and 60s. All these fucking kids, these special ed kids, they look like the fucking cartoon characters from the fucking 60s.
I was taken to the ghetto one time. That's the worst. When you get taken, you're not expecting to go. Usually you want to know when you're going to get it. Like, I'm going to see some wild shit. I got to prepare myself. I'm going to see something crazy.
See something crazy and fun. Yeah.
I had a limousine driver.
It was after a show.
It was like 3 in the morning. I had a limousine driver. He was a nice guy talking to me and shit. Oh, hey, where you from, dog? D.C.? Where?
They know you from the hood. They know you from the hood.
That's a rough scene.
They know you from the hood, Dave.
And the cell phone started ringing. Hold on one second. Hello? Oh, what's up, nigga? What? What the fuck? Slow down. What? What the fuck?
What?
No!
What, nigga?
No! No! Fuck that, nigga. Fuck it. I'm on my way.
Oh, yeah, we're coming. Hey, the phone. We're coming.
Hey.
Got a TV dance in the freezer.
I gotta make a stop real quick.
Say that for the morning.
At 3 o'clock in the morning. I didn't know he was taking me to the ghetto at first. I saw looking out the window. I was like, what the fuck? Gun store, liquor store. Where the fuck are you taking me?
Yeah, I guess we're
it don't look good. He didn't say shit.
They didn't say nothing.
Just pulled up in front of an old rickety building that looked like a project. Now,
especially fucking projects look like it was a fucking ghetto.
Certainly had all the familiar symptoms
like
of
fucking projects. It ain't coming from the projects with that shit.
A fucking crackhead ran this way.
Crackhead just ran through all the motherfucking projects, man. You probably see that motherfucker. You probably see that motherfucker.
And then another one jumped out of tree and shit.
Hey, jump out of trees too.
And I said, I'll be right back. And left me. He took the keys with me, just left me.
He just left you and then jacked your ass.
In front of a project in a fucking limousine. This was not good.
He jacked you.
I was like, man, I got to look around and see if I can see some landmarks and figure out where I'm at. I have to escape on foot.
Escape on foot.
Yeah, that's when I know I was
in the motherfucker alive, bro.
In the worst neighborhoods. Remember, it's 3 o'clock in the morning. It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
It's 3 p.m. I look 3 a.m. It's 3 a.m. in the morning. You'd be stuck in the neighborhood, the bald neighborhood.
Standing on a corner.
You're in a bad neighborhood standing on that fucking corner, Dave. No better. Back in the day, you should have tried.
And the baby didn't even look scared. He was just standing there.
The baby's gonna look at you, man. Like,
I mean, it made me sad, really. You know what I mean? Because I wanted to help the baby. I was like, I don't trust you either. I'm sorry. Click. The old baby on the corner trick, eh?
They tried that with a baby on the corner, man. That trick. It's the old trick they got. The baby on the fucking corner, man. Like, well, the old trick says shit.
I stopped feeling bad. As time goes by, I start feeling worse. Like, man, what is wrong with me? What the hell is wrong? I'm scared of a baby.
You're scared of a baby.
And this baby could be in trouble. He might need my help. I got to do something. But I wasn't going to get out of the car. I'm serious, man. I just cracked the window a little bit. There's a whole limousine. I can roll it down. Hey, baby. Baby, go home, man. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. What the fuck are you doing out?
3 o'clock in the morning, nigga. Okay, 3 o'clock in the morning.
I'm selling weed, nigga.
Oh, shit. 3 o'clock in the morning, you selling dope? You selling weed? Oh, shit.
I wasn't expecting that. I'm sure I had to buy 2 bags from the Coleman. I'm going to
get 2 bags. You got me fucking kids, babe.
That shit was scary, man.
It's scary shit. Yeah.
And look in the window. It was like Jurassic Park. And should he be looking all the time?
Yeah, Jurassic Park everywhere. Shit.
All right, get out of here, Cracky. That baby was still standing there, man. Then I started feeling bad again. Yeah, weed make you feel guilty sometimes. Though.
Man, what is wrong with me, man? I have just bought weed from an infant. Can't condone this kind of behavior. What am I thinking? I can't let the fear ruin my morals.
Don't let the fear ruin you. Shit.
Gotta do something.
You got the fear ruin your fucking morals. Shit. Do something.
Hey, baby. Stop selling weed, all right? You got your whole life ahead of you.
Stop selling weed, you dumb baby. Dumb baby, stop selling weed in the streets of D.C. Stupid baby.
Sam. And just at that very moment, when the crackhead was running across the street and got hit by a car.
Then the baby died.
I know it was a hit and run.
Then the baby died.
The police did it.
Then the baby died.
That's all right. They sprung some crack on him and got back up.
Then the baby died. It always happens.
Yeah, I'll be saying that kind of shit, man.
Yeah.
It's what it is. They use the TV to program us from a young age. You ever watch like a cartoon that you used to watch when you were little as an adult? Shit is wild shit.
Yo, it's wild,
some wild shit.
Shit.
I mean, like I was with my nephew. We sitting there, we watching Pepe Le Pew. And I said to my nephew, I said, now pay attention.
Oh, that's a Looney Tunes cartoon right there, man. The Pepe Le Pew cartoon. And that Candy Pew. It is red. It's a Candy Pew. Pew. It's like the cat. I mean, it's like the people running for a fucking cat. Guys back on the
see,
fucking got all the paint on his back or something. It's like it was a skunk. The cat the puke.
I had to turn the channel real quick. I turned on Sesame Street. I said, oh,
shit. Why Sesame Street, man? You're going to see it. You might go see Big Bird and Ernie and Bert and all of them shit.
But now I'm watching.
See Grouse Girl Grouch and all the motherfuckers, man. Go see them on Sesame Street, nigga.
Teaches kids
how to. I used to watch Sesame Street, bro.
And label people.
It's West right. Sesame Street, man.
They got a character on there named Oscar.
Oscar the Grouch, yeah.
Treat this guy like shit the entire show.
Yeah.
They judge him right in his face. Oscar, you are so mean. Isn't it, kids? Yeah, Oscar.
The kids see yeah, the mean. It kids like, has.
Bitch, I live in a fucking trash can.
Kids are like seeing Oscar Grouch in Sesame Street. They always feel like, oh no, Oscar Grouch is being so mean to us. What we do?
Then you wonder why your kids grow up and step over homeless people. Get it together, Grouch.
They gotta get it together quick. Good job, homeless people gotta get that shit together quick before something happened to them. Fuck.
They don't even tell me how to get to Sesame Street. That is a terrible place. I wouldn't go there right away. Who would want to live in a neighborhood like that? Fucking 6 foot pigeons walking around.
Yeah.
An elephant that's a junkie.
Big yellow fucking bird.
Hi, bird.
Yeah, big yellow fucking bird, man.
Yeah, that's right. Snuffy.
Hi, bird.
Snuffy. We found Snuffy. Anybody know Snuffy? What else next?
And Cookie Monster with his eyes popping out.
Cookie Monster.
Hey, cookie, like, yeah.
Cookie Monster?
What kind of cookies are you talking about?
Cookie Monster's talking about cookies. Cookie Monster. Cookie Monster.
And then had the nerve to put a pimp on there.
Damn.
They didn't come out and say he's a pimp, but I know a pimp when I see one.
Damn! Fucking cookie monster eating cookies, man.
Where is my money?
And the pimp comes. And the pimp. And then pimp wants his dough. His fucking dough. Pimp wants his fucking dough. Pimp will find niggas and find. Pimp will find anybody who's gonna give him his fucking dough. Shit. That's all pimps do. Shit. Pimps will slap bitches to get that dough back. Pimps will slap the bitches too. They'll do it. Ask for that cheese at. Alright, this ain't no blood red gun. It's a Geico red gun. I wrap around my fucking
thing. There's so much stuff to worry about. You know, the more you know, the more you don't know and shit. You know, like a lot of people be telling me, Dave, you know, you just gotta relax. The racism thing is bugging you too much. I be thinking about it. Sometimes shit will happen.
There's
a lot of black people can relate to this. Have you ever had something happen that was so racist that you didn't even get mad? You were just like, that was racist.
Racism thing is a big old issue.
So blatant, you were just like,
that's back in the day shit.
Like, it almost like it didn't even happen to you. It was like,
I talked about this. I
that was a
boasted about this shit till a week. Where that racism shit came from.
That happened to me. I was in Mississippi.
I was a fucking kid.
I was in Mississippi doing a show, and I go to the restaurant to order some food.
I already knew what racism was.
I say to the guy, I would like to have, and before I even think,
since all this shit happened on fucking, since this shit happened on fucking FBI files. You doing weird that with a fucking KKK. Try to start burning down churches that were owned by blacks.
Right.
Black
folks. How did he know that I was going to get some chicken?
Get some fried chicken.
I asked him, I said, how you know that?
I said, fried chicken, you hungry? Get some fried chicken.
How did you know I was going to get some chicken? He looked at me like I was crazy. Come on, buddy. Man, everybody knew as soon as you walked through the goddamn door, you're going to get some chicken.
It's like these motherfuckers. No, motherfuckers sound like that in Tennessee, though.
And chickens.
Yeah, motherfuckers sound like Tennessee. Motherfuckers in Tennessee. We don't find you act like that.
Yeah,
here.
I finally understood what he was saying.
That's
I
what he said.
Upset.
That's what he said.
I wasn't
Jack.
Even mad. I was just fucking upset.
Fucking Tennessee.
I wasn't ready to hear that shit.
Fucking Memphis police.
All these years.
Or Knoxville
I thought
police.
I liked chicken because it was fucking, delicious.
They fucking. Tell that shit to New
Turns
Jack.
Out I'm genetically predisposed to like a chicken.
About 94, whatever.
I said, why?
He tore that shit to him. Talked to that shit to him.
That's like
they had dumbness on.
I got ruined chicken for me. I'm scared to eat it in public. I don't
want somebody
to see me and
say, so
you need some chicken.
Eat some chicken. I'm hungry for some chicken. You scared to eat in fucking public, nigga. You eat some chicken.
Look at him.
You're scared of eating fucking public, dog.
He loves it.
Just like it said in the encyclopedia. Look how happy he looks.
He knows about the encyclopedia, too. Shit. That's a simulation shit.
Sometimes the world be too much to deal with. That show business be crazy. That's where the cultures really collide. Show business bring a lot of races together. Sometimes it works, sometimes it don't. This is one thing that happens that's funny. You know, sometimes I'll be on a business call, right? You know, like with a lawyer or something. You know, my lawyers be white.
Like,
we'll be on a call, right?
It's between 2 years of us, you know shit. Oh,
okay, Dave, we're gonna close the deal. Is that fine with you? I'll be like, yeah, that's good for me. Great. Great. You have a good weekend, Dave. I'll be like, all right, you too, man. Peace. All right, bye bye. I don't know what to say, right? So sometimes I'll make up shit that's not even slang just to see how they handle it and shit. It'd be the same business. Go, all right, we're going to close the deal. Is that fine with you, Dave? Yeah, sounds good to me. Great. You have a good weekend, Dave. All right, buddy. Zip it up and zip it out. Oh. All right. Zippity doo dah. Bye bye. Sometimes, you know, sometimes racism works out in black people's favor. Yeah, it doesn't happen often. It happens very rarely. But when it happens, it is fucking sweet. I'm serious.
Yeah, it's sweet too.
Sometimes racism saved my life, man. I was on a plane.
Oh, it saved your life or the racism shit. It saved your life, huh?
I was coming from overseas, and I don't know how this guy got a machine gun on the plane, but he stood up, man. He said, "Everybody, get on the fucking ground."
That guy got a machine gun. That guy got a machine gun.
I started freaking out.
He got some dudes with a fucking Chinese machine gun trying to hold the fucking green up, man. Shit.
He was screaming and crying. I was the only brother on the plane. Well, I thought I was the only brother. I looked over. There was one other black dude. He's from Nigeria. I looked over at him. He was looking right in my face, man.
Man, they go mistake you for a Nigerian person, bro. Babe, the terrorist gonna mistake you for a Nigerian guy.
He didn't need to talk.
They mistake you for a fucking Nigerian guy. They already know you from DC. They mistake you for a fucking Nigerian.
So my dudes on the front of the plane seen us. They were like, oh my God.
The fuck? How the fuck you go get on the plane with them terrorist sons of fucking hoes? The terrorist sons of bitches, bro. How the fuck you gonna get on a plane with those terrorist sons of bitches? How you gonna get on a plane with them? These motherfuckers got machine guns and shit. Get ready to hold the plane up. Get ready to hold the fucking plane. Hold the motherfucking plane up. God damn it.
Don't take black.
How the fuck you gonna
that's the truth.
You gonna be on the fucking plane.
On the news.
And all of a sudden the plane get hijacked with you in that motherfucking thing.
They is treating us good. We all chilling and shit. I like to give a shout out to Ray Ray and Big Steve and
Ray Ray. You and Big Steve and Ray Ray, you shout out, man. Yeah. Fucking nuts. You got shout out to Ray Ray and Steve.
You're not gonna see it. Terrorists are smart. They know what they're doing there.
Terrorists will do anything, they bro. Terrorists will do any fucking thing. I swear to God, they'll do anything, dog. Terrorists will do something.
They called the White House. Hello? We have got five black. Hello?
White House. Motherfucking White House. They get on the phone to call DC, call the White House.
You'd be back in DC.
That's what they did.
This is an election year. I'm gonna ask you, white guy, do you know who you're voting for yet? Don't know, do you? Now you see that?
Yeah.
You see what just happened here? Let me tell you something. That is a cultural thing. Mm-hmm. He knows who he's gonna vote for. He's just not gonna tell me. See?
No, watching Dave Chappelle killing him softly.
That is a cultural
22-year-old special.
White people do not talk about your political affiliations. It's a secret. You ever ask a white guy who's voting for you? Hey, Bob, who are you going to vote for? Dave, whoa.
Yeah, you used to do him.
This is
long before the Chappelle show.
So anyway,
killing him softly.
I was fucking my wife in her ass, right? And I mean, it was something else. Yeah. But who are you voting for? Dave!
Hey, no, come on. Oh, the Moby Franklin guy. See, they only did that shit.
Ask me all these questions.
That show got canceled.
Like the bulge that information because it matters to them. Black people talk about that shit. Black people openly talk about politics. Black people openly talk about beating up politicians and shit.
Black people be a politician. You still want to try that? What are you trying that shit? So black people be a politician. I don't think anybody will try that shit.
What are you just saying?
That's not just so. It's like, motherfuckers might go catch goddamn assault charges.
Black people see, even when I vote, right? Which I don't.
Don't catch cases like that shit.
But even when I like think about like who I would vote for, right? I don't even look at their political policies. I just look at their character.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying now? You got to read. No, I'm serious. You got to read between the lines.
We
like, you know, you look at Clinton and black people like Clinton. We've seen him on a campaign. I saw one thing on a campaign trail. He actually just picked the black baby up and killed
the Clintons. Bill Hillary. Bill Hillary, man.
I like that.
Yeah.
He did not hesitate or nothing. See, George Bush Jr., he be then.
Yeah. George Bush Jr. Yeah. Some of these people used to be presidents before Barack Obama and Donald Trump.
I never vote for George Bush Jr., but I don't know George.
Now we got politics. Now we got Joseph Robinette Biden Jr.
That guy
as president.
That's right. Now listen, we cannot have that shit in the White House. That might be fine for a mayor, but goddamn it, not in the White House. You know what I'm saying? The stakes are too high in the White House.
Yeah.
Can't have no coke here present.
Damn straight.
He be selling nuclear secrets for $20, $30 and shit.
Yeah. Goddamn straight.
Could be meetings embarrassing America. Come on. Sign a treaty, baby.
Sign a treaty. Oh, no. This is all they worry about is blowjobs.
That's not how we do business here, sir.
That's all they worry about is
sucking the ambassador's dick.
Now the ambassador's worried about getting his dick sucked by the president. What a fucking joke.
There will be peace in Israel, finally.
Presidents don't perform blowjobs on ambassadors. They don't do that type of shit. Fuck no.
I'm just looking at his behavior.
I smell that shit.
I understand that kind of behavior. I know a lot of dudes with them shortcomings.
That's weird shit.
Weed smoking fornicators. There's a lot of them.
Yeah.
I mean, come on now. Let's be honest. Bill Clinton was not the first president to do what he did. Let's think back for a minute. Remember a guy named Kennedy, John F. Kennedy?
Yeah.
Remember him?
R.I.P.
Marilyn Monroe.
R.I.P.
Matter of fact, him and his brother Bobby fucked Marilyn Monroe.
They're like a bunch of sleazy shit.
Because those two pages in history are stuck together.
Sleazy shit, bro. Every time.
They will get that on.
Yeah, like Marvin Gaye. They get on.
I seen the tapes. Remember the tapes? She'd be singing on there. She was partying, stressing them out. Mr. President. Bitch, my family's here.
My God. What, man? The family's
Clinton
here,
did the same thing. But he didn't do it like that. Because it's the year 2000. He's busier than Kennedy was. He's a busy man.
Yeah.
Clinton did that kind of thing the way busy men do it.
Yeah,
you know what busy men do? They fuck who's close to them. I can tell that's what Coleman was up to. It looked like he just stuck his head out the office door and said, oh boy. You, come here.
What? You following them? Follow me. man.
Get us up from a 3:30. Come on. Oh boy. He's probably looking at Kennedy's pictures, yo.
Ew, JFK pictures. You look at JFK pictures. That's all before JFK was assassinated in Dallas, Texas.
Top it off, he lied.
1963, man. In Dallas, Texas.
I did, man. I know how you did.
Anybody knows.
I've been accused of having sex with a girl I've not had sex with before. Let me tell you something. That shit is infuriating.
That shit only happened to me 20 years ago when I was in St. John's High School.
Touch that bitch, nigga, I'll kill you. Fuck you, nigga, I'll kill you.
That shit happened to me when I was in St. John's High School while I was fucking one of my sister's friends. That my sister used to go to school with.
Clinton came out of the press conference all relaxed, shoulders all relaxed, and all this trouble. Look like he just got
my girlfriend. She called me dead ass. She called me dead ass slippers.
Let me tell you something.
I was in that classroom.
I don't think you heard me first time.
I used to do sleazy shit 20 years ago.
Sexual relations with that woman.
Whoa.
Miss Lewinsky.
That only happened with Monica Lewinsky and ex-president Clinton. Everybody knows that Bill Clinton was fucking that white bitch, bro. The guy's dick sucked by that white bitch, bro. It was a couple years younger than he
Nobody
is.
Cared. We all watched. We was disgusted, but we kept watching the news. I know I did. I was taping it.
Taping the news about Mark Lewinsky and Bill Clinton, man.
Every week on 60 Minutes was a different girl accusing Clinton. Remember Catherine Miller came out?
Yeah.
She was upset. The president called me into his office. He...
Keith Kirk would have found out about that shit.
Sarging my breast. Slowly. I'm sorry. And then he placed my hand on his genitals. Ed Bradley was shocked.
Yep. Ed Bradley is shocked, bro.
Was he aroused?
Ed Bradley was shocked. He heard about this shit.
I was like, was he aroused? Or?
He got aroused badly. You watch the tape.
And then Ed Bradley looked right in the camera. He said, "Don't bust that nut yet. We'll be right back."
Oh! Oh, man!
Oh, man.
All right, back. Don't bust that nut.
But there were no victims. There were no victims. Only one I feel sorry for is that Lewinsky.
Lewinsky's old. Oh, she's gonna be exposed, man. She's gonna be exposed, man.
That's a hard thing to be famous for, man.
That Mark Lewinsky's gonna be exposed for fucking ex-president Clinton.
I feel bad for her. Not even the women feel sorry for the ladies.
Even though Bill Clinton's own wife Hillary wanna know about this shit.
That's what that is. I mean, come on, if that's one dick that girl sucked, it's gonna haunt her for the rest of her life.
It do.
Long after she spent that money up, that's still gonna haunt her.
It will. It'll haunt her badly.
There's a lot of women in here with at least one dick they regret.
Yeah. That's all she gets. That's all she gets for sucking Bill Clinton's dick.
Kenny's shoes, a Safeway, or something like that.
That's all she. That's all Mark Lewinsky gets for sucking ex-president Bill Clinton's dick. Also, she will get the ride, bro. Also, she will get the ride.
And she made a mistake that young girls make. She wanted to fuck a powerful man. Period.
That's all she wanted to do. That's all Mark Lewinsky wanted to do.
How powerful the president was.
That's all years ago.
Older woman would have helped everybody. Older woman would have been in there. You know, you should lower taxes. Older woman would have sucked us into a utopia.
Hey, I wipe all the fucking dirt.
Last one was everybody.
All my motherfucking Yankee head.
Famous. I have dreamt of being famous, but I never dreamt of being that famous. I never understood how famous a president was, but imagine if somebody could suck your dick and then they're famous.
You know what I'm saying? That's worse. That's more than you get by being famous and
that's crazy.
Being known.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, no guy ever thought of that. There's nobody with a pickup line that good and shit.
They suck my dick. There's a future in it.
What? It wasn't some future.
Oh, that's it now. Get out there and be somebody.
Oh, well, they do it. This they say. Get out there be somebody. Say.
You're a qualified author now. Go write a book. Said, I'm in the wrong business.
That's like my character said.
See, the only reason I want to be president is because I'm black.
Trying to write a book. They said, don't.
I mean, you know, I mean, says, I think don't take me black to president one day, but.
He says, don't take me to him.
I mean, second or third, that's fine, but
I'm trying to write a book.
Watch out. I'm
trying to write a book.
I'm too hot. I mean, I'd be the first black president. I don't think that nobody would really, really hurt me. I'm sure somebody want to hurt me, but I don't think they touch me because my vice president will be Mexican for a little insurance.
Mexican vice president.
You know what I'm saying? And you can shoot me if you want, but you're just going to open the border up, so. You might as well leave me and Vice President Santiago to our own devices. Ain't that right, Santiago? See?
He was our own devices. They all said, he said, you were the fucking Mexican Vice President.
Elian can stay.
Can he?
Don't worry, don't worry. Can he? I got no Elian jokes. All I'll say about Elian is thank God he's Cuban.
Elian Gonzalez.
If he was Haitian,
why that would be Elian Gonzalez, man? The Elian Gonzalez. What the fuck?
If Elian Gonzalez was Elian Mumbo from Haiti,
they talk about Elian Gonzalez or Elian Celian Weber's glasses and shit. Get the ribs out, shit.
Oh, the only thing in our society that bothers me the most is the way that men and women don't get along no more. That's really what's bugging me about it. Men and women just don't get along. Like I hear
they
women say this all the time.
They try to not get along. Like,
chivalry is dead. Don't y'all feel that way?
That kills
like
chivalry.
Men aren't gentlemen anymore.
That kills chivalry.
That's right. Chivalry is dead.
That kills chivalry.
Women killed it.
It kills chivalry. Chivalry is about to die. How many brain cells that Harry had to die?
There's a fundamental difference in the way we're going to see things. We're not going to see eye to eye on this issue. We're just not. Our tests in life are different. A woman's test in life is material. A man's test in life is a woman.
Wow.
Now, by test, I mean that those are the things that we desire. Men have nice cars. Not because they like nice cars, because they know women like nice cars.
Women do like nice cars, man.
That's how it goes. Because men are hunters, and the car is the bait.
Yeah.
And a woman comes and says, ooh, nice Porsche. Gotcha, bitch.
Whoa. Down with the Porsche.
That's how it is. That's true. Come on now. You go to a woman's house, her house be comfortable as shit. Women love comfortable surroundings, so men get comfortable surroundings. Let me tell you something. If a man could fuck a woman in a cardboard box, he wouldn't buy a house.
Why do it? Why do it, though? By fucking them in a cardboard house.
Chivalry got killed. Chivalry got killed
by
the feminist movement on the
that killed chivalry. Chivalry would have died.
Too much advice about men from other women.
That's what they say. Chivalry is dead. It's dead.
It's true.
It's
I see this shit in the magazines.
It happens in the mags too.
I look at every in the grocery store. The fellas, you look at one of the magazines. Like, what is this? They say a cover. 100 ways to please your man by some lady.
100 ways to please some man.
Get out.
Oh shit.
Ain't no 100 ways. Shit. This is four nigga. Things long. Just suck his dick.
Oh
balls,
shit, and nigga.
Fix him a sandwich and don't talk so much.
Oh shit, nigga. Oh shit, nigga. Working for the ribs.
And then the magazines trick the women. The magazine stop picking at your self-esteem. Every page you turn, you start feeling fatter and uglier, and you feel like your clothes aren't good enough. And the magazines have you forgetting how fucking beautiful you are. And that's what happens. Now look what happens. And then you forget how beautiful you are, and we all suffer. If pussy was a stock, it would be plummeting right now because you flooded the market with it. You're giving it away too easy. I'm just being truthful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I'm just talking.
You had to. You talked about it.
It would plummet. You'd be watching the news today. Pussy plummeted again.
Oh, the pussy plummet. The pussy plummeting again.
Gold is up 10 points.
Gold is up 10 points, you say?
You can see it. Yeah, that shit happened. This is how confusing
that shit's
it
funny.
Is. This is the practical.
This is hilarious, man.
I'm talking about. Like a guy be out, just having a lot of guys. You be out of club, all right. He's kicking with your boys, and a girl walks by, and man, she looks good. She looks good, not good in that classical way. I mean, you know, I'm talking good. Like she got half her ass hanging out her skirt.
Yeah, it's hanging out the ass is hanging out the skirt
all
though.
Mashed together, popping out the top.
I seen this.
And shit.
I seen a lot of people naked on the Naked Truth, bro. I seen the Naked Truth. Fat people, bro.
And you
show off all their
right?
nakedness.
You and your buddies, you got a couple of drinks here.
I already seen that shit.
You might try to talk to it. It might not come out right.
I already seen like previous Wednesday.
Damn, look at them titties.
Look at them titties. That's why Punk said, they own the titties.
Wait a minute. Just because I'm dressed this way does not.
This is a big pun stuff. So I pay for these things. Get your own. That's what big pun is rapping is.
Which is true.
So hard shit.
Gentlemen, that is true.
That's what before big pun died. This is song called So Hard. This is before he died in the early 2000s.
But ladies, you must understand that that is fucking confusing. Yes, it is.
That's a confusion there. You can't get.
Now, that would be like me, Dave Chappelle, the comedian, walking around the streets in a cop uniform.
Why dress up in a uniform like you're a police, man?
Us. Come on, they're over here. Help us!
What?
Oh, man. Oh! Just because I'm dressed this way.
Like the police. You dress like you're the police.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's like, all right, lady, fine. Fine. You are not a whore. But you are wearing a horse uniform, I'll tell you that something. Little misunderstandings can happen.
It do happen.
And then men, we misunderstand women a lot.
Back in the day,
you know,
would.
We always undermine their feelings. You can't do that to them. You can't. Because, see, feelings are, see how they're clapping. Feelings are very important to women. They are all important to women. I'm just learning this shit.
That's feelings for you.
Everything's based on how they feel. You can hear when I tell stories. You ever hear a man tell a story, it'd be just facts. Who, what, when, where, why.
Yeah.
It was me and Bob, we was at Safeway. And that nigga Bob said this, and I punched that nigga, and then I broke out. That's the story.
You punch him and break out anyway. You punch him and break out and get out there. Then you punch him and then break out.
Women have got stories and all these feelings. And, well, first of all, you have to understand, I was on my period, and I just talked to my mother, so I was feeling like, ah, damn, it's too many feelings.
That woman's on her period, bro.
The fuck happened? It do it.
Oh, man.
But I got to talk about them. Got to talk about them. That's how they always get me. I've been sitting there watching TV, chilling and shit. My old lady come up to me.
Yeah.
David, we need to talk.
Oh, y'all need to talk. Y'all need to talk. Need to talk.
I don't say that out loud. That's how I feel inside. Because I know every time we need to talk about some shit that I gotta do.
But what else
talk
can
about
you
do?
She
needs to do.
What does she do? What that woman does?
She leaves me defenseless. I have to do what I have to do. David, we need to talk.
That again?
Nah.
Again?
Don't do that to me, David. This is serious. Stop talking in that voice. Now say. I gotta do this.
Shit. Shit. It sound like fucking Rocky from goddamn WB cartoon.
I complain, but I'm happy I'm with somebody.
Sound like Rocky from WB cartoon. Shit. Like come here.
Sometimes you're in a single club, you see too much. I was on the road one club and I seen a thong contest.
Thong? Yeah. A thong contest? What? A thong contest? What?
Yeah, I seen a thong contest.
What?
Yeah, it's some scandalous shit, all right.
Oh, man. A thong contest?
I couldn't get over that, man. Because a DJ, you know, I was dancing with a girl. And he just said, everybody that wants to be in the thong contest, please report to the DJ booth.
Excuse me. That's what we're billing the goddamn wet t-shirt contest. As far as I'm asking.
Them girls was going off. Some of them pulled their pants down, some pulled their skirts up.
Yeah.
Shaking their butt. Some of them didn't have underwear on. They was just fucking.
They shaking their girl asses when they got no drawers on.
Was fucking disgusting. But I couldn't.
They only got thongs on. I see nudity there and there.
All right. One of the girls is so into it. There's no cops around, right? But she actually, I'm sorry to tell y'all this, she spreads her butt cheeks open. She spreads her butt cheeks open in the middle of a crowded disco, right? Yeah. I was disgusted because I was like 10 yards away from her. I was like, oh my God. Is that her birth canal?
Yeah, it is her birth canal, Dave.
Oh, it gets worse.
We finally seen it.
God almighty, is that a baby?
It's a baby. Yeah, it's a baby.
Gross.
Yeah, it's a baby.
Because it was a baby.
Yeah, it was a baby. Yeah, baby, come on, birth canal is every day.
Like, I'm stuck in a club, nigga. I got that weed if you need me.
Fucking go get high. Oh, fucking get high when you play with a fucking baby.
Guys, thank you very much.
Oh shit. What? That's fast? Holy fuck. Oh, that fast?
Good night.
You call this fast, huh? Shit, what's going in? I don't know what's going in. Yeah, that's all the families that's going over there. What?
Live from the Murat Theater in Indianapolis. From the Kings of Comedy, the Platinum Comedy Series presents D.L. Hughley, funnier than ever before.
I knew it.
They got commercial after this fucking video. Yeah, commercial right after this comedy special.
September 11th, we should have been in there. September 11th and a half. It never would happen. Subway Airlines. All the black people with $27 tickets to Detroit.
It's our show commercial regarding D.L. Hughley right after the Detroit comedy special went off.
Hey, Bill, you in peace? I bet I'll be there tomorrow. I'm in peace, my foot up somebody's ass. Don't play with my money like that. Black folk and white folk, we don't have our problems before. We be damned if somebody new gonna come in. These are our white folk. Y'all leave them alone, man. That ain't racist, that's American. And racism is more American than apple pie.
No topic is safe. DL's back with
some what need to be said.
Coming to a store near you. It's the comedy concert the world is
getting. They got two commercials at the comedy special with all. You got D.L. Hughley, you got D.L. Hughley, Finch, you got to go with Cedric the Entertainer. Like anybody remember him from Comic View and shit?
Outright hysterical.
Hysterical is right, folks.
One of the original kings of comedy, Cedric the Entertainer, and it started live.
This was before, after Kings of Comedy special.
This concert is guaranteed to make you laugh.
You gotta keep your ID in. You can't let your ID come out like that.
Let me
there. All right. Yeah, he acting funny.
Laugh like you never have before. It's the comedy concert the world has been waiting for. In stores now.
They got the ball now. Contact comedy. Got the ball on them shit.
Cedric the Entertainer and the Starting Lineup.
I'm going to do my thing. It's going to be a lot of fun tonight, but this is what I call the starting lineup. They're great. They perform with me all summer long. You will be entertained. Plus, I'm going to be doing my thizzle, too.
You know, your time is running short.
For all the American flags on your car, and you ain't got no damn insurance or nothing like that, nigga. I'm just, police like, he's a patriot. Let him go on through. He's
Cedric the Entertainer, starting lineup, part two. Coming soon to home video.
Misty Hobby Boy.
The man.
The man. That's what I'm talking about.
They got Steve Harvey.
Outrageous comedy.
Jesus, what's going on?
Direct from HBO, it's Steve Harvey.
This is great.
You better not say what I think you about to say.
Shit. I'm talking just wear your ass out.
Holy
the
shit.
The comic genius of Steve Harvey and the kick-ass special that leaves the others behind.
You know, there's a couple things you can wear to bed like a G-string. Ladies, when we see a strain, go down and crack a yo ass.
Oh!
I don't give a damn if when the strain go down there, we don't see it no more. As long as we know it went down.
This is a comedy special that my late grandmother Jordan Coleman hated. It's that comedy special that Steve Harvey used to be doing.
No, he's Steve Harvey.
Tiger Woods!
In his HBO special, coming soon to home video.
Go see what happened in Chicago. You go from Chicago.
Get your hands together for Michael.
Go from Illinois to NY to DC and shit.
Just when you think you've seen it all.
Oh, Michael Coyard. Everybody remember him in Showboat, bro?
Remember
him in Showboat from House Party 3. That's Michael Coyard. He used to play Showboat on the House Party 3 show.
Three
House Party 3 movie, remember him? Remember Showboat on House Party 3?
Now he's going back to where it all began.
This guy has his own comedy special too.
Get ready to meet the man.
And I mean the real man.
Who tells it like it is.
I didn't want to be ready. I had to. I can find a good weed.
A 1-hour comedy special. The Michael Collier Project.
Yeah.
Coming soon to Urban Works Home Video.
Skip home.
Urban Works probably. Hey, I released my Urban Works though. I ain't had a chance to look at that fucking shit. That's Platinum Comedy Series, baby.
All right, like everybody think my name is like Tyra Banks, but like my real name is Tyrisha Banquette.
That's Tyra, folks.
Since I was like 13, and like he's straight funny, and like y'all need to watch him and straight clowny because like back in the day, like when we was chilling in Inglewood, like Alex would be having I'm Tyra Banks. Watch Alex Thomas straight clowning because he
Alex Thomas is clowning, dog.
A true
you see him on up in smoke tour.
Check out.
You see him up in smoke tour with Dr. Dre and them. You see him up in smoke tour with Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg and all of them, bro. Dr. Dre will watch this shit too.
Dr. Dre, and what y'all need to do is check out my man Alex Thomas because he's straight clowning. Can I get my money in?
Get Dr. Dre his cheese, man.
Yo, what's up? This is Jimmy.
What's up,
man? Alex Thomas, straight clown.
Yeah, I'm rolling with Alex Thomas and the K-Star Wall Snoop Dogg. Alex Thomas, West, y'all. He's straight clown.
Yo, this is Shaq. Check out Alex Thomas, straight clown.
Shaquille O'Neal.
It's the first annual Shaquille O'Neal comedy roast, starring Queen Latifah.
Ghost is Shaq.
They're ripping him, dissing him, talking trash, cutting the big man down the side.
Shaq, you got the whole S on the thing. Don't you think that's a little 13, a little 14, okay?
I think that's had a really big heart. He got some big ass teeth.
Tommy Davidson from A Living Color. He was in that roast too.
Fighting skills, cause you ain't slipping, rocking, flipped your ass.
Well, the toys, I think it was Guy Toy.
Shaquille O'Neal, and you'll see him like never before.
He'll show his ass, bro. He'll show his ass for everybody, bro.
His head is huge.
Bill Bellamy right there. Michael Coyard.
Guy Tori. You're embarrassing. Well, or probably Joe Tori. I don't know.
Put my hair on your face like.
Pound for pound, the funniest comedian on the set today. The Platinum Comedy Series presents the host of BET Comic, Bruce, like you've never seen before.
Oh my God! Is it
me? Oh, come on, man! Man, look, Bruce hit it. Make the host come out there, let Bruce hit it.
Somebody breath be so bad you can see the words come out their mouth.
Man,
Bruce
hit it.
Yeah, I see what you're talking about. What's up, player? Everything all right?
He played security guard on the wash. Remember him?
Don't put him in there. Put him in there. You grab him, you in trouble. He's a ninja.
Whoa.
You should have let that mama say ninja. Hell no. You want to make me mad? You got me Popeye's chicken going out of here.
Love that chicken.
Bruce is funny, hilarious, larger than life, and he's coming to a store near you.
Shit up.
Soon.
There's a cuss this shit up, man. Yeah, this is shit up, man.
Got an extra coming up. Oh, man. Don't move. I got an extra coming up. Don't move, man. Guys, so coming up, man. Be back with extra, man. Be back with you, man. See you tonight.